You think he was really trying to get an advantage over you guys, or was it a simple mistake?
Again, I have to give the man the benefit of the doubt until he messes up. That's what my father always said. You give a man a chance to prove you wrong. He produced all the documents that they required. He said he ate the meat. To me, he ate the meat.
What do you think about Charlo calling him out after his fight, saying he wants Triple G? Is that a legitimate fight, or did he need more time for that fight? Even what do you think?
You know what? Before Saturday, everybody was asking me about the other guy, that FIB, the IBF guy. Now he's the flavor of the week now. And if Murata wins next week, they can be asking me about Murata. No disrespect to anybody. But there's a lot of promoters and managers in this room disguised as journalists. Everybody knows what the next step should be. But yet nobody's ever had a chance to guide a fighter. You know, everybody's got an opinion. Like I said, last week they were talking about Dibrachenko. This week they're talking about Charlo. What's going to be next week? The unfortunate thing is that you guys don't realize that there was a short period of time. And let me go back even further. Back in 2016, in September, we fought Khan. Mm-hmm. And then we were supposed to fight. I wanted him to fight like the fans want him 3 or 4 times a year.
Yeah.
And we proposed the fight in October to Jacobs. The same people that have Jacobs, manager and trainer, have Dibrachenko. But yet, at that day, they said that their fighter needed 12 weeks to prepare for a fight against Golovkin. How come Dibrachenko can be ready in 3 weeks? I don't get that. I think it's just, you know, and you guys fall for it. You guys, like, you just hook, line, and sinker. And what happens is that, I'll ask you another question. Has that guy been tested?
Charlo?
No, Dibrachenko. You guys were pushing 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago. He hasn't been tested. He hasn't submitted himself to any kind of test. Yeah. So are we starting again the same thing that fight falls out? The only reason he's fighting on the 5th is because we didn't listen to any of the criticism, and we didn't listen to any of the criticism that we know in our hearts that it can't be made. So if it can't be made, why even worry about it? So we went in a direction where a fight can be made for the 5th. For the fans, if Gennady is going to fight 3 or 4 times a year, like everybody wants, like you guys keep saying, it's impossible for him to fight the elite fighters 3 or 4 times a year. Impossible, because there's not that many elite fighters. He'd be fighting Joshua in 2 years. Well, he'd run out of elite fighters. So these fights have to happen for him to fight 3 or 4 times a year. It's impossible for him not to fight these fights without. And if they want him to fight 3 or 4 times a year. And Chavez had those fights. Hopkins had those fights. Go back and look at the records. These fights are necessary to give the fans what they are asking for. And that's Gennady in the ring.